In this chapter, there is one example of NCERT in which we have to prove that the distance covered by a free fall body which is falling from some height and the distance covered by this body is in the ratio of odd numbers in equal intervals of time. So let's prove it. First of all, we know that acceleration due to gravity is always acts in downward direction. So here, if the body is in at some height, so when it falls in down in this direction towards the earth, so its gravity is acting in this direction. So here we are taking g as negative in this direction. Thus, in free fall, we take g as negative, and the distance covered by it is given by y is equal to ut plus, in case of gravity it is minus half gt square. Here, when the body is at some height and which is at rest, so here it is zero, so we can write the position of the object is given by minus half gt square. Let's consider a situation in which the object is at this position at some height, and when it at t equal to 0, height covered is 0, and at time t the position of an object, let us suppose it is y, at this position its value is ut minus half gt square, so it is half minus half gt square. And after covering an equal interval, that is 2t, its value is, or its just position is minus half g 2t square, that is 4 is outside and minus half gt square. So let us give another position, that is y naught. Minus half gt square is equal to y naught, and therefore we can write 4 y naught is another position. This is y1, or the position of the object is 0. Position at time t is y1, and here it is y2, which is equal to 4y0. Similarly, after covering an equal interval, that is after time t, it is equal to 2t plus t, that is 3t, and the position of the object is y3, is equal to again minus half g t square, that is 3t square. 9 minus half gt square, and it is equal to 9y0. So y3 is equal to 9y0. Furthermore, we can write at equal intervals, it is 4t, position of the object is y4 is equal to minus half g 4t square, 4t whole square, and it is equal to 16y0. So we can write y4 is equal to 16y0. And as we know that this is the motion in a straight line, that is one dimensional motion, therefore magnitude of displacement is equal to distance. Thus, we can find the distance covered between the time interval 0 to t and the time interval between 2t and t, between 3t and 2t, and 4t and 3t. That is, let us suppose it is, the distance covered is h1, it is h2, it is h3, and h4, and so on. So here we have to prove that these distance covered is in the ratio of odd numbers when it covers equal intervals, when it falls in equal intervals of time. That is, here the distance covered is, that is h1, in time interval t minus 0. That is, here we can write y0 minus 0 is y0. And the distance or the magnitude of displacement is 2t minus t. During this time interval, here it is 4y0 minus y0. That is 3y0. So we are getting the term y0, 3y0, and now h3 can be written as height between the time interval 3t minus 2t, in time interval 3t minus 2t, and it is equal to 9 minus 4y0, that is 5y0. Similarly, y4 minus y3 gives height h4, that is 4t minus 3t gives displacement h4, that is equal to 16 minus 9, that is 7y0. So here we can see that the ratios are h1 is to h2, is to h3, is to h4, and so on, is equal to y0 is to 3y0, is to 5y0, and so on, 7y0. Or we can write 1 is to 3 is to 5 is to 7.